you know, this was a huge, you know, bounce back game from that. Just coming in, you know, another great team. They've been playing great. You know, we really needed this one for our confidence and just to get headed on the right track we wanted.
It was Utah's first win versus Duke since 1970. Number one, Michigan State, no issues with Northeastern, 78-58. Denzel Valentine, 17 points, 6 assists, and 5 rebounds. The Spartans, they're 12-0. Number 8, Virginia, top number 12, Villanova, 86-75. The Cavs shot 66% from three-point range. Number 10, Xavier, cruised by Auburn, 85-61. Jalen Reynolds, 18 points and 6 boards. As the game is winding down, North Carolina leads UCLA. Final minute of play, 89-72. A couple of games at the half. Kansas all over Montana, 44-24. Oklahoma, 45. Creighton, 38. And Miami leaves Charleston, 41-32. Some breaking news. Kyrie Irving tweeted out, "I'm back," and it's believed he'll make his season debut on Sunday against the Sixers. The Jets, they travel to Dallas, meeting up with the Cowboys tonight at 8 Eastern. Dallas head coach Jason Garrett praised the Jets' offense.
He's a good player, and they have a good football team around him. It starts with their offensive line. They do a good job running the football. They control the line of scrimmage. The runner's outstanding, a physical downhill runner. The two big receivers are outstanding. I think as much as anything else, he's got a great feel and understanding for the system and does a good job just running the offense and getting the ball to the playmakers.
And bowls have kicked off. Arizona leading New Mexico 14-3 at the New Mexico Bowl. I'm Keith Irizarry. This is NBC Sports Radio and the mobile app.
This is KCAA.
If you're like me, you like to go to garage sales to search out all the bargains. You might even love to hold garage sales to sell all the stuff you and the family doesn't need anymore. But the big drag is you just don't like the back and forth until you finally give up and sell that old lamp, which used to be your grandmother's, for way less than it was worth. Well, now those days are gone, especially those Saturdays. Let me introduce you to BuySellMakeOffer.com, the new and revolutionary way to buy and sell online by using video and Skype to sell your antiques and more. You'll be able to experience a virtual garage sale from the comfort of your couch. Go right now to BuySellMakeOffer.com and type in your email address so we can make sure you're on board when we launch January 15th. BuySellMakeOffer.com is going to make history, and we want you to be a part of it. That's BuySellMakeOffer.com. Join us.
As the owner of my business, I wear a lot of hats. I'm accounting, sales, and so much more. But I don't know marketing.
Let Dex Media be your marketing department. Our team can create a digital plan for you with everything from search to social. Contact Dex Media, that's DEX Media, to get found, get chosen, and get talked about.
Whoa, that's a job for cleanup, which would be me.
Call 844-230-3436 or visit dexmedia.com today.
Hey, Di, do you know that many people have no idea that the Carousel Mall is actually open?
What? Do you tell them that that's where KCAA is located?
Of course, but there's more than just KCAA here.
Oh, I know. It's a totally great place for a girls' outing. Here at the Carousel Mall, there's Mega Beauty Supply.
And it's huge.
Yeah, the biggest beauty supply store I've ever seen. And they have wigs and extensions.
Then there's Backstreet Beauty Salon and Daniel's Jewelers, a store, by the way, for girls and guys.
Yes, and Nail Fashions, where they do waxing and eyelash extensions. There's Lisa's Threading. You know, Mark, eyebrow threading is a big thing nowadays.
I do know about Mr. Yu's.
Yes, when you're ready for lunch, it's Mr. Yu's Chinese Restaurant.
Mm-mm, best of all, Mr. Yu's is right next to KCAA.
Yes, all this located in the Carousel Mall, right off the 215, the 2nd and 3rd Street exit.
Come visit the Carousel Mall. We're open.
For more info, go to kcaaradio.com.
Switch Reels Gospel Hour is a show designed to enhance our lives spiritually, mentally, and musically. I'm your host, Elisa. Join us for the fun of learning every Saturday
from 6 p.m. to 7 p.m.
on KCAA 1050 AM and 106.5 FM.
E-Digits. Lock them in for more information, recreation, and guaranteed fun. KCAA.
Oh, Welcome to I'm Mad as Hell with Lloyd Brock and Greg Simpson. Now, if you want to share your anger, this is the station, KCAA, every Saturday at 12 noon. If you're mad as hell at the government, politicians, IRS, your bank, a car dealer, or the court system, let us know. You may want to be one of our in-studio guests, or just call in and vent that anger. 1-888-909-1050 or 909-888-5222 locally. We may not be able to resolve your individual problems, but we will give you a forum to share your anger with our listeners. Now, join us at KCAA 1050 AM and at kcaaradio.com or check us out at Ustream. Now, here's Lloyd and Greg.
Uh-oh. What are you mad about this week?
Well, I'm mad as hell. Bah humbug.
Bah humbug?
Yeah, bah humbug.
Oh.
A lot of things going on nationwide, locally.
Right.
You name it, and
it's
happening.
Huh? Okay.
And today's L.A. Times, right here.
Okay.
And there's an article here by Christy Parsons and Michael Mamoli. It says the shooting that led Obama to go off script on gun control. As everyone knows, he was here in San Bernardino yesterday evening.
Yeah.
Yeah, and, you know, he
media
was...
Media picked it up. I seen it on the news.
He went to our local airport, and I thought, that's kind of strange. It's not a military base anymore. I thought he'd go to March Air Force Base
or
in Riverside.
Yeah. Sure.
But, of course, you never know. But he did come right almost downtown. Because it's right there.
Right, miles
but
away.
He was thinking of going off script. He's talking about gun control. And even on his way to Hawaii, because of all the shootings and things that have happened, and he's thinking about executive order on gun control waiting for Congress to do anything. And his ideas are kind of archaic. Because I know I'm all for not having people die because of guns.
Yes.
But it's not background checks that are going to be the thing that solves the problem. Because 93% of all gun crimes in the United States are committed with stolen weapons.
What do you think? Law enforcement, maybe? Better law enforcement? Better after the fact? Identifying guns and not letting them...
You can't get inside a person's brain and understand where they're coming from and why they've got all this hate.
Yeah.
And one guy says, well, let's tell everybody to love everybody. How about that?
Yeah, well, that's
they could
good.
Love everybody, you know? Oh, come on, peace and love.
Yeah, it's good.
And it's not going to work.
It doesn't work. That's right. You can love some.
What was that saying?
Yeah,
I
had a stain. It says, statistics show criminals commit less crimes after they've been shot.
And that's absolutely true.
Yeah, absolutely.
And as they say, our prayers and condolences go out to the families that lost loved ones, and this
or the
holiday
loved
season,
ones that were injured. Some were injured, you know.
Yeah, and I noticed that he talked to the victims of the ones that were murdered, but not the ones that were wounded.
Yeah, I guess he didn't talk to any of the wounded people. You know, I don't know if he was.
Well, he didn't have time.
In a rush, he must have been
in
a rush.
In a rush to go to Hawaii, I guess.
I would be too.
But his regulation, his aides don't know what he's going to decide on the executive order. And basically, he's looking at canceling or making it illegal for all, gun shows. He wants to close them down completely everywhere. And they've been a tradition in every state for years and years. And I'm sure that they're going to get some opposition on that. But if he does an executive order... What are you going
to
do?
Yeah, you can't do anything. You have to wait.
What are you mad as hell about?
Well, right now I'm mad as hell. I was reading about, he's a YouTube star. He's 15 years old, and he has an entourage of older people that are of age, and they got caught soliciting 12-year-olds for sexual exploitation. It didn't say just exactly what they were going to exploit him for. I can imagine all kinds of things.
Oh, yeah, I read about that. The girl turned him in, though.
Yeah, the girl turned him in, said she was lured off the streets and hoped to meet in celebrities. That's what the ruse they were using. And it, and an unprecedented deal. They named this guy. He's a Compton skateboarder named Stephen Fernandez.
Yeah, he's only 15 years old.
Only 15 years old, but they named him in the hopes that if he's if he's done it and hurt some girls and what have you, that they might just come forward and turn this guy in. But
His manager and another skateboarder were also involved in this, and they're 22 and 27.
Yeah,
I think
that's the whole deal. You know, they got these adults there that are promoting this, maybe for their own game.
Yeah, maybe he's doing it for them.
Maybe he's fronting for them. Who knows?
They should lock them all up.
Yeah, they should definitely lock them all up, and they should.
But if there's any victims locally, because this guy's been all over the place.
He's been everywhere, yeah. He's
got a clothing line and everything else.
Yeah, he's gone big. He's gone really big. So, you know, if you've been confronted or this guy is and his entourage have tried to lure you off the street, or if they have lured you off the street, come forward and let them know so that they can get justice.
Say, we've got a caller.
Okay.
Yeah, good afternoon. Who are we talking to?
Hello?
Hello?
My name is Richard Harvard. Russ suggested I give you a call at this number because I was telling all mad and how I was about the government.
Oh, yeah. Well, let us have it.
Blame it all on the government. I blame it a lot on the voters.
Well, I mean, that's true, too. You can see how uninformed
hear you.
Well, as I say, you can see how uninformed they really are when you see the man on the street, somebody, you know, interviewing.
I can hardly hear you.
Oh, well, I can hear you fine.
Yeah, you coming through good, Dick.
You want me to tell you what I got to tell you?
Yes, sure. Tell us.
You can interrupt me any time.
Okay, let us have it.
Well, I'm mad as hell at the president. I'm mad as hell at the Congress, both houses. Because the Congress has been in the Republicans' hands for 2 years, and they've done absolutely nothing. And this is the worst president we ever had. I'm 81 years old. I was born when Franklin Roosevelt was president. And I've read books on every president since. I've read five on this president before he was even voted. And the first one was enough to get me not to vote.
Oh.
And then I found out that the guy that done his Obamacare, he called American voters stupid, and I agree with him. Half of them are, including my sister. I was talking with my brother one Christmas about 3 years ago, and my sister said she voted for Obama. I said, what? And we both said, what? And if you got a good reason, that's all right. So we asked her reason. Her reason was he wore $600 pair of shoes, and he had a nice suit, and he talked nice.
Oh.
I said, that's no reason to vote for a president.
No.
I read five books on president. One was called Gangster Government, Corruption, Culture of Corruption, Crimes Against Liberty, The Sobering Love Affair with Obama, and another one was called Catastrophe by Dick Morris. But anyhow, this president hasn't done anything for the country. He's gone around the country and called it, saying that we were not an exceptional country, but we are an exceptional country.
Yeah, I agree.
Who's
with you.
Also,
he
who's your
apologizing for all of us Americans? He don't have to apologize for us Americans.
Yeah, that's
best
true.
There is that, and that's the main reason he's no good. But he's been bad for the economy, bad for everything. And I don't know how we're going to stand him for one more year. If we don't get a good president next time, this country's doomed.
Who's your favorite?
Another thing is dooming this country is the debt. When we have to, eventually we're going to have to pay a penalty. We won't even be able to pay the interest on the debt.
Yeah,
it'll probably be close to $20 trillion by the time he's out of office. And once it hits $24 trillion, that's higher than the gross national product of all the United States, and then we're dead. We're dead beat in the woods. Okay.
Who's your candidate, Dick? Who do you favor right now?
For next year?
Yeah, for our next election.
I know one thing, that I don't think Plum will get get elected. I think it'd be either Rubio or Cruz. Texas, what's his name?
Cruz, yeah.
I think it'd be one of them too.
Okay, well,
I'm not
thanks.
Not sure who I'm voting for. Yeah.
Thanks for the call.
Really, that's over a year away. We got to put up with this president until January 20th, 2017.
Okay, well, thanks, Dick. We got to go to commercial. Thanks for the call. Call anytime.
Yeah, okay. Thank you very much.
Okay, buddy.
Bye. Yeah, we're going to break. Kcaa, 10:50 a.m. and now 106.5 FM. And this is I'm Mad as Hell.
With Lloyd Brock and Greg Simpson.
Wow, am I thirsty. Whoa.
Are you really?
Yes.
I think you should come up to Oak Hills Brewing Company, home of the best brews in the high desert.
High desert? That's where I'm from.
Oh, do you know Floyd?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Say hello. Brother Lloyd. Yeah, yes. I know him.
Say hello to Floyd. Founded by two entrepreneurs, these big dreams turned into Oak Hills Brewing Company. They have yummy brews, select ales, craft ales, craft sodas, root beer, ginger ale, and cream soda for the kids.
How many?
How many kids?
How many brews?
I don't care how many kids come up.
Oh, okay.
They have 3 brews.
Okay.
For kids. Then they have 13 brews for adults.
Oh, love it. Love it. Love it.
I'm glad. Oak Hills Brewing, Mondays 5 to 9, Thursdays 3 to 9, Friday 1 to 10, and Saturday 1 to 10. Oak Hills Brewing Company.
I'm going up right now.
Do you know how to get there?
Yeah, almost.
Okay, well, let me just make sure. 15 north to the 395, pass 2 signals, turn right on Poplar, and you're there. OakHillsBrewing.com.
On my way.
Thanks for waiting. Lloyd and Greg are back.
Yeah, we are. We're certainly back.
We're certainly back.
I'm glad we're back. But
that caller certainly had an opinion about our government. 81 years old, and he sounds like he read a lot of books and had a lot of knowledge. And,
he's not happy.
He's not happy, very much so.
And yes, we were supposed to have a guest in studio, but he had to postpone it. But it came about from this article in yesterday's L.A. Times.
Okay.
And it was L.A. County weighs in requiring gun insurance. Now, this is...
Gun insurance.
Yeah, they propose these things. It says the insurance policy would be similar to a car insurance, making payments to offset the cost of victims and public agencies if the policyholder's gun is used to injure or kill someone. What if it's stolen? Am I still responsible?
That's what it's saying.
Well, it's not now.
Oh, yeah.
But if you get insurance,
yeah,
I guess
that's what
it would
saying,
be.
The insurance, just, you're responsible.
These are proposals.
Yeah, that's...
And Adam Winkler, a law professor at UCLA who studies gun laws, said the insurance requirement could reduce accidents and suicides by getting people to store their guns more securely or to purchase smart guns that can be fired only by the authorized user. But here again, storage of guns, you know, if you got a gun safe and they say, well, I've got a gun safe. Somebody breaks into your home and they say, oh, wait a minute. Wait, hold on. I got to get my gun. It's in the safe. And the guy's going to say, okay, go ahead.
Okay, yeah.
just go ahead.
Yeah, go get it. I only got a knife, so you just get your gun and do me in now.
But, you know, this is kind
it's
of ridiculous. And the guy that was supposed to be here, he says his name is Stan Roy. And he's out in the Antelope Valley, but he had some business to take care of today. And the Christmas season is very difficult to get people in the studio.
It sure is, yeah.
But he said, are law-abiding gun owners to be punished for the act of criminals? That's what Stan said. And he said he's actually a National Rifle Association certified shooting instructor. And he asked the supervisors there in L.A., he said, are we to think that people committing armed robberies, rapes, and homicides are going to pay for insurance? These are stolen weapons in many cases. How are you going to, you know, keep that responsible? And they said, well, you're responsible for that gun, and if you register it, insure it, the next step is taking it away.
Sure.
It hasn't passed yet, but this is...
Yeah, anything that messes with what we already have. We have enough laws on the books to regulate anybody's gun. There might be a little kink here, a little kink there, but like the Riverside guy came that manufactures these guns and sells them all the time. He stated that to protect our Second Amendment right, we have more than enough laws on the book.
Well, no, that was Centerfire Firearms.
Yeah.
Over in Riverside, and basically he doesn't manufacture them, but he's got one of the biggest, and I guess sales are going through the roof.
Yeah.
But and they are everywhere.
Right, everywhere.
And just, what is it? I forget how many millions were sold recently. Well, and in light of what happened here in San Bernardino and here again, those two guns that killed those people were not even registered to these people.
Now, even if you
would have insured them, then who's going to be responsible? The people, the two dead people?
Yeah, the dead.
Or the guy that just, the bottom of just was arrested?
Yeah, he'd be responsible. The dead people would be responsible. I guess their family would be responsible.
It's just, I mean, it's
who
ridiculous.
Knows? The insurance policy was written. We got enough insurance.
Well, I mean, you'll get arguments on the both sides of this, but I'm sure that it wouldn't pass Congress, but it might pass the L.A. supervisors.
Yeah, it might
or
pass
the state
that.
Of California, because Jerry Brown is so...
Or the president get a hold of it. Watch out.
He's... Jerry Brown wants more gun control, too.
Yeah.
But, and then you...
For
shooters.
Me, more gun control would be to go to school and learn how to control your gun you just purchased. And that would be gun control as far as I'm concerned. Because your person has to control what he has, make it safe, make it unavailable for kids.
Anyway, he's going to be, Stan Roy is going to be in studio in the next few weeks.
Okay.
Sometime.
Good.
When he can make it here and we can talk more about this and what they're doing up in the high desert where he's from.
Where they have more freedom to shoot. They're used to have. I don't know if it still exists.
Well, yeah.
Used to be able to shoot at 22 or, you know, do some shooting up there, plinking or whatever. But I don't know if it still exists anymore.
With the new regulations,
yeah,
you never
know.
But as I say there, there was an article, too, about...
I missed this. On those two that killed all those folks in... in San Bernardino, the terrorists, one of their targets was the Riverside City College. It was near the top of their target list.
Yeah, this just came out the other day about the other targets.
Yeah, they had several targets, I guess. And
well, this is back 2 years ago, I guess. And
just, yeah, 2 years ago they arrested some folks that had already planned it and were already conducting a deal, including the guy that bought the guns for these two.
They just arrested him.
They arrested him, prosecuted him, and they give him long sentences. All of them got long sentences.
Oh, this was before?
Before this, when this was done, there was a cell, I guess, that they should have identified, and these guys were loosely tied to it. The guy that bought the guns was directly tied to it, and they actually were going to do another one. Then, and the guy got cold feet, the guy that bought the guns. So, I mean, this is ongoing. This is just the opportunity of a peaceful party and people that weren't armed or ready.
Well, I mean, I think he was going to say they were going to shoot people from... They were going to put a bomb in the main part of the school, and then they were going to shoot people as they came out.
As they came out, yeah.
And then they were going to do something with the freeway, with pipe bombs.
Yeah.
I mean, it could have...
Well, they had pipe bombs here. What were they going to do with those? They had one tied together, three tied together.
But they had
a dozen more? Who knows what they were going to do?
They were going out other places.
Who knows why they went back and then were going to leave again? I think they got interrupted.
Well, the whole thing boils down to people that we thought we could trust.
Yeah.
And you...
Well, that's it. They ate with these people. If you didn't think you could trust them, you wouldn't eat with the individual. You wouldn't talk with him. You wouldn't argue with him.
They had a baby shower for him.
Yeah.
And they were trying to reach out and love
and
one
love
another.
One
and
another,
peace.
That's right.
And it doesn't
when you don't
work.
Love back, you know, it's tough to love. And you got to extend your love. I agree there, but you got to draw a line too. And if this guy hates you like they hate us, how in the world can you just reach out and love? You have to reach out in love, but you have to reach out, well, maybe arm too, to protect yourself from getting your head cut off.
Of course.
You know,
because, you know, my brother who lives in Arizona said, and I've reminded people, in that state, open carry is all right, concealed weapons all right.
Sure.
If this would have happened in a county facility in Phoenix, Arizona, with about 50 people in there, I guarantee you at least five would be carrying weapons.
Sure, there would have been a lot less deaths, a lot less wounded.
People would have been killed immediately.
Immediately, sure.
Somebody would have got a shot off.
Sure, they would have.
And that's why they don't go there.
Yeah, that's why they don't.
This was a gun-free zone.
Yeah.
Just like all schools are gun-free zones.
The targets are organized for them. Gun-free zone. Where do you go shoot somebody? You don't want to shoot
them. Well, and then they've advocated, some people were advocating, that the teachers should be armed. And they said, no, you can't have arms around children. Well, if somebody comes in with a gun, that's all over.
It's all over. If you're unarmed, you're dead. It's that simple.
It wouldn't happen in Israel because everybody's carrying
a gun. That's right. Israel knows.
I'll bet you
terrorism.
I don't know about the teachers there, but I guarantee you they've been trained in arms.
Sure.
And they probably have one in their schools. And if somebody knows about this, call us.
Yeah, Dr.
Call us anytime. The local number here is 1-909-888-5222.
Long distance is 1-888-909-1050.
Yeah, and if you have, as I say, information about what's happening in Israel, how they can keep those schools safe, or anywhere else.
Yeah, anywhere.
You know, that I've got friends that are teachers. My grandson's a teacher.
Yeah.
And they're concerned.
Oh, yeah, they're very concerned. I know
you can't have, you have metal detectors in L.A. for people coming in the front door. And with knives and weapons, but there's weapons out there that don't show up on a metal detector.
911 sure was done without guns.
Yeah,
they took down a lot of people with a little planning. That's all it takes. Guns are more useful for the honest person than it is for the crook.
Yeah, but you've got to. We've got so many students. That have gone radical.
Yeah.
And they get their parents' guns. Here again, they didn't do a background check on these children, teenagers, or anybody who goes to college normally. They're using their parents' weapons.
Sure.
And a lot of times that's happened. And here again, it's stolen from the parents. We don't say where it's stolen, but if it's taken from the parents, no amount of background checks are going to make any difference.
Any difference in the world. That's
whatsoever.
Right.
And then somebody came up with an idea to have a psychological test for everybody who wants to buy a gun. We've got to take a break in a few minutes, and we've got a caller.
Okay.
Should we take the call now or what? They can hang on for just a few minutes.
Okay.
That should be good. Yeah, we can go to break. And as I say, you're listening to I'm Mad as Hell right here on KCAA 1050 AM and now 106.5 FM. We'll be right back.
Money, money, money!
Most of us need extra money. Well, if you own something of value, go to Rich's Jewelry and Loan in Ontario. He'll loan you money on jewelry, musical instruments, tools, electronics, and almost anything of value. Or if you prefer, he'll purchase the item from you. And if you need a great buy in diamonds or a Rolex watch, Rich can save you hundreds of dollars. Don't waste time. Go to Rich's Jewelry and Loan, 124 West Holt Boulevard in Ontario. Give Rich a call. 986-2604, and tell him what you'd like to sell or bring in for a loan.
Loan, loans, loans!
Rich's Jewelry and Loan, 124 West Holt Boulevard, Ontario.
Just when you thought you couldn't wait any longer, Lloyd and Greg are back.
Yeah, we're back.
We're back. Let's
we got somebody on the phone that's mad as hell. Good afternoon. Who are we talking to?
Yes, good afternoon, gentlemen. This is Art from Riverside.
Hi, Art.
I'm glad you guys are on 106.5 FM now. Congratulations.
Thanks.
Thank you.
I am a substitute teacher. I don't want to carry myself.
Yeah.
But those that are trained to carry or security personnel, I have no problem with that. I substitute sometimes with the San Bernardino County Superintendent of Schools, and they wand the students. I think that's good. And they should be able to carry it. All the school districts should have their security personnel with gun permits. I don't want the liability myself. I know that the children need to be safe, but I want the experts, I want the security people to take on that responsibility. I don't want any mishaps or accidents, or what am I going to do with the gun? They'd have to have gun safes in each classroom. It's a good idea, but I'd prefer to let the security personnel handle that aspect and stop them at the front gate rather than get to my classroom.
Well, I understand, but I understand in Arizona some of the teachers carry there.
Carry anyway, huh?
Well, yeah.
Well, it's legal, though.
Well, yeah, it is legal, but I'm not sure on their gun-free zones. Normally the schools, are gun-free zones everywhere, and that makes them a target. But you have to worry about the individual student that might be a sociopath or mentally ill in some way.
Sure.
That wants to, they get in an argument with another student or have a bad grade from a teacher and want to kill the teacher. And these things, they happen all the time. But they usually, with the social media out there, they usually go on Facebook and tell people what they're going to do. And
before they do it, yeah.
That'll stop them. But
air marshals, though, I think a few should be armed in a few classrooms, just maybe like an air marshal type thing.
I could go for that.
Well,
even though I think Donald Trump's a bloviating blowhard, I really do believe he's correct. When he should have said, we need a moratorium for the Muslim cultural community just for our security, our safety right now.
Absolutely.
Well, did you hear about yesterday? They were in Congress, they were asking the people from the FBI and everywhere else. They said, we've got 120,000 visas that were revoked. And they asked them, they said, where are these people? They didn't have an answer. They couldn't tell anybody where those 120,000 visas that were revoked. And I think, I forget how many were actually on the terror list.
Probably
and they
bunch.
Don't know where these people are. Now, the system...
That's a disgrace.
Well, that's...
That is a disgrace.
Yeah, that's... The system's broken. Yeah. And we've got those same people in our environment. You have them in Riverside. We have them in San Bernardino.
Got them in Los Angeles. They got them in...
Well, yeah, these visas...
Anywhere.
Well, that K-1 especially, there's a problem there.
Sure.
They weren't allowed to use social media to do a background.
Yeah.
And that friend of mine...
Mr. Obama, why were you so late to the table in reaching out to these families? I know you came in yesterday into the airport. Why were you so late to the table when even the FBI called it terrorism? You're so politically correct. And with all due respect to victims, I think some of these individuals are too politically correct. This gentleman made threats before. They should have reported them.
That's right.
And all these parties are going to have security and wanding. And it's unfortunate that our society has gotten to this point, but you're just going to have more security at these events and not take it for granted that it's just going to be a jolly good time.
I agree.
Well, he was delayed because of somebody shamed him. A lot of people said, you should have been there. You've got to go there. And he said, well, I'm going to Hawaii anyway. I might as well stop
by, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. That looks bad. Okay, I'll just stop over and. Meanwhile, I'll go on to Honolulu and.
That's true.
La 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 la.
Well, how can we fix the system? Do you know a political
system?
You got
an idea?
Anyway, do you have any ideas about that?
Well, it's. It's a change. You know, I grew up with Midwest values. It's a change now with hip hop, and you know, we're almost I don't want to say too diverse, but there's been a great cultural demographic change, and a lot of people don't have the same values that you and I grew up with.
Absolutely,
it's really really a shame. And I think ever since 1965, when we allowed the last 50 years of everybody to come in here without screening or diversity's fine, but if you don't assimilate too, then you have a hodgepodge of knuckleheads that are bent on destruction and mayhem.
Well, that's true, and that's we've got certain. You can go to the DMV, and how many languages are listed on that
exactly.
for driver's tests and things like
unbelievable.
This. You know,
exactly. Not to single out ethnic Mexicans, but it's too easy. I mean, the proximity to Mexico and you know, it's just too easy. They don't need to learn English. They don't need to learn the language. They're pretty well isolated, especially here in the Southwest. They can live pretty comfortably just speaking Spanish and doing whatever
true.
They'd like without assimilating now. So,
sure.
Well,
that's the way it goes. That's the way it is.
How much more money?
We're going to turn back the clock, but that's the way it is.
What about the breakdown of families? Do you think that's part
absolutely.
Of our problem?
Very
I do
good.
Too. I do
yes.
too.
The breakdown of families, absolutely a part of this.
I agree.
And he was this kid that shot up this young man who graduated from Cal State. This Muslim gentleman who was influenced by his wife, he came from a broken home, so the dad wasn't there. So,
sure.
Well, that's true.
That had to be a factor, and it affects young men drastically. Divorce and especially the father figure not there.
You see that in school a lot, don't you? And when you're teaching, you see a lot of sad people with broken homes, and you can pretty well know who they are.
You do. You're empathetic. You try to, you go on with your school day, but you're definitely sympathetic and empathetic to children's plight. You know, I just the high schoolers are a little more they hide it a little bit more. But
do they?
Even they are affected. But you can definitely see it in the little ones, the younger ones from eighth grade down.
Okay.
So it's rough.
Yeah, but the poverty.
You try to do your best, but that's all you can do right now. Yeah, I mean, you're not their parent. You got to watch out for liability, unfortunately.
Sure.
It's not like the old days, but you do your best.
But the poverty level is so high, especially in San Bernardino County. And it's just, nationwide, here we are giving billions and billions of dollars to these countries that hate our guts.
Hate us.
And we can't even feed the poor people. The kids that really need it.
Yeah.
And this, I played.
Counseling, you can't afford counseling.
Yeah.
You know, you get them in a counseling session and money runs out and the counseling stops. You know, I've been affected by it.
It's just, I see it played out all the time. It's just not a happy picture. And my grandson, who's a teacher, and he sees it all the time.
All the time, huh?
Kids aren't the only meals they get are the ones that the school provides.
Well,
in many
you can
cases.
Blame the government for closing down Norton, which destroyed San Bernardino. That was a major factor in wrecking the city. And the council people were overwhelmed. And there's a big difference. Even James Fallows wrote about it in the Atlantic, and he grew up in Redlands.
Yeah.
About the difference between Riverside and San Bernardino is night and day. I mean, next to Detroit, San Bernardino is a devastated wasteland. I mean, it's terrible.
Yeah.
It's going to take a lot of work to bring San Bernardino back to a middle class community. I don't know if it's going to be possible. It may take
I don't think it's another
possible. 50 years.
Well, it's sad to say, but that's my hometown. I was born there. I don't tell people. I live in Redlands, but only 8 blocks from where the shooters lived. But here again, I've lived in San Bernardino before, but I moved. and the crime rate is very high. But Kaiser Steel, when they closed too, they lost a lot of jobs in there.
Yeah, Norton, when it went down, and some of the others. I lived in San Bernardino. I was born in San Bernardino myself.
Yeah, and, so it's...
It was okay for a long time.
We're really concerned about it, but I never thought they would ever do anything here.
No,
that was a spotlight on San Bernardino.
Or something. Yeah, I never thought so either.
You know, you always assume that it's going to be somewhere else, like a major sports stadium.
Anaheim or someplace where there's
The Disneyland.
Disneyland, always, yeah.
They've increased the security there.
Sure.
And in Las Vegas.
Yeah.
And now... we've got word secretly from the from an FBI source that says that within, the next 3 months?
3 months, yep.
That something else is going to happen here.
Something.
Not necessarily in California, but a major...
terrorist event, yes.
Yeah, and they're preparing for it.
You know, every school is vulnerable, though. You know.
Yeah, but I'm really worried about celebrating the first... The new year.
The new year, yeah.
And that would really be, everybody assumes that it would be right downtown New York.
Or Vegas. Las Vegas has a huge New Year's celebration.
They close down the street and people just want thousands of people go there.
Yep.
So I'm not going anywhere. I'm staying home.
Yeah, I've been staying home for a while. So.
Well, we appreciate your call.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Feel free to call anytime.
You're doing a great job. Merry Christmas. Happy New Year.
Yeah, Merry Christmas. Happy New Year to you, bud. Take care.
Have I? Yeah, this is a big problem, and I just see.
It is a big problem.
Let me read you something here.
Let's hear this.
Somebody sent me this the other day, and occasionally we find an email that has a lot of wisdom and random thoughts, and it says, as we grow older and hence wiser, we slowly realize that wearing a $3,000 or a $30 watch makes no difference. They both tell the same time. And whether you carry a $3,000 purse or a $30 wallet or a $3,000 wallet, the amount of money inside is basically the same.
The same, right?
And then it says whether you drink a bottle of a $1,000 wine or a $10 wine, the hangover is basically the same.
The same, right?
Although, people will argue about that.
Oh, sure.
Just whether the house we live in is 600 or 12,000 square feet, loneliness is still the same.
That's right.
In time, you realize your true inner happiness does not come from material things of this world. Therefore, I hope you realize when you have old friends, brothers and sisters who you chat with, laugh with, talk with, have sing songs with, talk about north, south, east, west, and heaven and earth, that it's true happiness. There's five undeniable facts in life. Don't educate your children to be rich. Educate them to be happy.
That's right.
It would add... As well as, and I should add, as well as godly.
Godly, yes.
So when they grow up, they will know the value of things, not the price.
Right.
Most valuable advice in nutrition, eat your food as your medicine. Otherwise, you have to eat medicine as a food.
As a food, yeah. Okay.
And the one who loves you will never leave you, because even if there are 100 reasons to give up, he or she will find one reason to hold on.
Isn't that the truth?
There's a big difference between a human being and being human. Yes. Only a few really understand it.
I think that's right. I think that's true.
And you are loved when you are born. You'll be loved when you die. In between, you have to manage. If you want to walk fast, walk alone. But if you want to walk far, walk together.
That's right.
Six best doctors in the world: sunlight, rest, exercise, diet, self-confidence, and friends. Maintain them at all stages of life and enjoy a truly healthy life.
Yeah.
We have to go to a break, and we'll be right back. You're listening to I'm Mad as Hell on KCAA 1050 AM and now 106.5 FM.
We ain't gonna take it. Oh, we're not gonna take it.
Is it that time? Your car needs a smog check? Well, check out Quick Smog Check in Montclair. They guarantee your vehicle will pass or you pay not a thing. That's right. If it doesn't pass the test, what the heck? You don't have to pay. So what's the reason why you're not calling them? The number 909-626-5436. You can also drive right down there now, 5438 Holt Boulevard in Montclair. They're open 9 to 5, 6 days a week, Monday through Saturday. Do it now. No wait smog checks at Quick Smog Check in Montclair, 909-626-5436.
Still mad as hell? Lloyd and Greg are back.
Yes, we are.
We're here.
Oh, on a happy note.
Go ahead.
Happy note. One of our sponsors here, Oak Hills Brewing Company in Hesperia, Santa Claus will be making a visit there at 3 o'clock today up until 6.
All right.
So if you got little kids, they're very welcome, even at this brewery.
Yeah, very good.
They have food. And, you know,
food. And good. Good time, huh?
So they should, they want to meet Santa, go up to Oak Hills Brewing Company. Here's another article that I found quite interesting.
Okay.
How Marco Rubio is quietly killing Obamacare. Did you hear about that?
No, I didn't. Yeah. That's a new one for me.
He said the battle against Obamacare has been Cruz's signature struggle. And 2013, Cruz took to the Senate floor and promised to speak out against Obamacare until I am no longer able to stand. To fill the time, he even read Dr. Seuss, Green Eggs and Ham. His filibuster and the government's shutdown over Obamacare launched Cruz into a political stratosphere, actually, inspiring conservatives eager for a principled fighter who does not back down. But while the shutdown may have helped boost Cruz into the top tier of the Republican presidential contenders, it has zero impact on undermining Obamacare. Whereas Rubio, by contrast, didn't read Dr. Seuss on the Senate floor, but he has quietly pushed Obamacare into what may provide a death spiral.
Oh.
When the Obama administration was crafting Obamacare, it came up with a crony capitalistic solution to entice reluctant insurers to join the exchanges. Many insurers worried that there would not be enough healthy people paying in to cover the costs of sick people. So the administration created a risk corridor program to help prop up the insurers who lost money in the first 3 years of the law. Now, present insurers would pay some of the profits into a pool to help insurers who lost money. If the amount insurers lost exceeded what the companies paid in, we, the government, would step in and make up the difference, calling this a taxpayer-funded bailout for insurance companies. Rubio last year quietly inserted language into the omnibus government spending bill that barred the Department of Health and Human Services from dipping into general funds to pay failing insurers, while the Obama administration can still administer the risk corridor program for 1 year at least. They won't be able to use taxpayer funds to bail out insurance companies after that.
Oh, my goodness.
So right now, quite a few are already losing so much money, and we're reimbursing them now for the first year. But they're going to pull out of the system, leaving millions
without
insurance.
That's right.
And United Healthcare is the latest one, says they don't know how much longer they can go because they lost
They're the big one. They're the one that
$700 million loss.
Oh, my goodness.
So, I mean, what is this? What's the effects of this? They want to, Obama wants to reverse this, but it did slip through. So that's to Rubio's credit.
Credit, sure. Somebody's out there working for us. We just got to find the right one and put him in the office and see what goes from there.
Well, there's so many problems now with Obamacare because the premiums have gone up because they're losing money.
Yeah, well,
there's not enough sick people to...
It never was something that would work. It was never, ever meant to work. It was
they
meant
didn't
to
think,
fail.
Well, Hillary came out with a program of her own, you know,
sure.
when Bill was in office. But,
yeah, I remember that.
And it failed miserably.
It failed miserably.
And it was very similar to this.
Of course.
But, you know, there were so many problems, and there still are. And there's still no protection for people who sign up for that as far as, you know, being hacked.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
And, the people that administered this weren't vetted properly.
Yeah.
They didn't check their background to find out. They could steal this information and probably already have.
Already have,
in many
sure.
cases. And
sold
and,
it for profit, didn't, done all yeah. kinds of things, sure.
You had an incident where...
Yeah, I don't want to talk about it right now.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Okay, this is...
you can't.
I can't, right. I got the muzzle on, but that's okay.
But there are scams out there.
There are a lot of scams out there, a lot of things that are being done that
especially around Christmas time.
Yeah.
And if it sounds too good to be true and there's upfront money, forget about it. Don't do it.
You got hit by one with a known company. They got you for what, $5,000 from a mailer?
Oh, they tried to.
Yeah, okay, they didn't.
They just tried.
Okay.
But, there's a lot of different ones out there, especially on home ownership
sure.
and rent. They're renting houses they don't even own.
Sure.
And that's happened here in San Bernardino Riverside.
That's been going on a long time, too.
It's so ridiculous.
New flavor on it, you know.
And it seems legitimate. The paper looks good.
Sure.
And they say they're real estate agents and all this jazz.
Come
and you can buy these papers. You can have them reproduced. You can make up your own from an old one.
Sure.
And they look legitimate. And they say, all right, we're going to do this. Now we need your $2,500 as a down payment here. And you go, and some of these people have actually moved into their homes.
Oh, yeah, been there a while.
And a month or two later, that somebody says, hey, that's my house.
Yeah.
What are you doing living here?
Caught.
Yeah. And they're left without... the
remedy, I'm sure.
Yeah, no place to go.
Yep.
But there's, there's one every day.
Absolutely. You know, I talked to my wife before I come on the show, and this is a good thing. She was talking about the Christmas season, and I have to make an announcement. It is Christmas. Everybody, you know, be happy on this Christmas time. If you can go and take your kids to see Santa Claus, do that. Go see Santa Claus. Do something fun like the old days when Christmas was a different story. It wasn't so commercialized. Do something fun with your family and...
It's not a holiday tree. It's
no,
a
this
Christmas
is a Christmas tree.
Tree.
We know what the season's about,
yeah.
And people know what the season's about. Let's go back and let's try it and see what happens. You know, my wife with love. We've been together 46 years, and she's always had a beautiful Christmas. Always made it beautiful, whether it was just her and I or a whole slew of people. So you know, just try it, guys.
I was married for 53 years and.
Same
my
thing.
Wife passed about 6 years ago.
Yes, that.
And, you know, Christmas is never the same because she always loved it.
Sure.
And I don't even feel like putting up a tree.
Yeah, but you still do your part. You play,
well,
play Santa
everybody else
and you
does.
Make people happy. Yeah,
yeah
you've got your part. It changed.
Well, you can see our desk here.
Yeah, it's all decorated, loaded.
You know, it's just, it is a season and we want to celebrate.
Right. And our the owner of our station, he's a Christian man, and I'm sure
right.
he's celebrating a Christmas. And
we want to see everybody else, and schools have taken the option that we don't want to be sued, so if one person objects, we can't call it a Christmas tree, we can't call it a Christmas pageant.
We just
it's a holiday event.
Yes, exactly, a holiday event. And we know better than that. This gentleman here, he was telling about he wouldn't carry a gun because of the liabilities. You know, there must be some huge liabilities for our teachers that we don't know about.
Yeah, that's true. And that they say the maybe that's why they're bringing on the insurance policy and saying, hey, this is what we need.
But you're a longtime dad if you don't have something to protect our kids. And they're so vulnerable, you know.
It is. And as I say, this is a season to celebrate. And
yes.
that children, you know, I recently, I don't buy many Christmas gifts anymore. I buy Christmas gift cards. because I don't want to keep the receipts and then people take the item back. Oh, it didn't fit. It's the wrong color. It's this or that. Here's a gift card for this, this, and this.
I don't like gift cards. I'd rather give money. I don't like gift cards.
Well, gift cards are money.
Yeah, I know. I still got two of them 10 years old.
You do?
I got old ones. Yeah, they're still good, but I don't like gift cards. Sorry.
You give them to me? I'll utilize
them. Other people like them very fine.
Just say, well, I got this. And my wife was always very careful. She said, well, you've got four gifts for this child, this grandchild. You need four gifts for this one. I said,
my wife is the same way.
Why is it
going to
be equal?
Same way.
The parents may not like that aspect.
Yeah.
And wait a minute, you spent too much money over here. Let's make sure it's going to be equal all the way through.
I'm always messed up there.
I can't wait until next year. The new year starts, then it'd be all over, right?
That's right, for sure.
And the bills start rolling in.
And then you start paying what you made for this Christmas. So what?
Well, there's people out there that don't have anything
that's
either.
Right. That's
so
right.
So donate generously. There was an instance.
Where you come in. A lot of the stuff is donated gifts that you pass out.
Yeah, that's true.
You know, and you help these kids that don't have anything.
But
I think it's wonderful, Lloyd.
But, you know, we had an incident a couple of years ago, and I won't mention what city, but I was playing Santa.
Uh-huh. Oh, yeah, all that good stuff, yeah.
And we had this little girl, she sat on my lap, and I said, what do you want for Christmas? And she said, well, Santa, if I could just have a new pair of shoes, I'd really like that. It just tore my heart out. I mean, her shoes were tattered and torn, and I didn't know. I felt like giving her money and say, go over there and get you a new pair of shoes. But, you know, I didn't know the parents maybe would use it for drugs or needed it for food or something else. And I couldn't do anything. And it felt, you know, this. My heart goes out to these kids. And you don't realize I do functions for some of the rich people in Redlands.
So, you get to both
sides. And I see those that have and the ones that do not have anything.
Boy. Yeah, I hear you.
And when I asked these kids, I said, what do you want from Christmas? And some don't even answer. They turn around and look at their parents because their parents probably said, don't ask Santa for anything.
I got it.
Because you're not going to get anything. So they don't. And I never promise anything. I always say, on Christmas Eve, how about I surprise you?
Yeah.
But, you know, this
you have to be very careful. I know.
But you can't. You don't know what the parents can afford.
Yeah.
So these are all things that are very important in this Christmas Eve season. And I always give to the Salvation Army because they do so much good for people. They don't ask for religion or anything else, what you belong to. They just help.
Yeah, we were going to give a bunch to Goodwill, and then I figured it out. Goodwill is richer than Trump, you know.
Yeah, that's true.
They got more money than
so anyway, I want you all to have a happy holiday. We'll be back next Saturday.
Yeah, we'll be back for New Year's for you guys, but have a merry Christmas and ho-ho-hos and all those old Christmas carols. They're still fun.
And you can see Santa up at Oak Hills Brewing Company.
Yeah, you can see Santa at Oak Hills Brewing from 3 to 6.
Yeah, that's right.
3 to 6. And who knows, you might come to Redlands and see him almost anywhere.
Next Tuesday.
Where's that?
Fleur-de-Lis. Okay. And downtown Redlands from 1 to 4.
Okay, good. 1 to 4.
Fleur-de-Lis.
Fleur-de-Lis.
Yeah.
Santa will be there.
State Street.
State Street in Redlands.
That's right. Come on down. Bring the kids.
Yeah, of course. Thank you guys for listening.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to all.
This is 1050 AM Kcaa Loma Linda and 106.5 FM Yucaipa.
Your NBC Sports Radio update starts now.
Duke gets dropped. I'm Keith Urizarry. The Blue Devils and Utah, they were in a battle.
Thornton turns the corner. Thornton shot blocked. Bottoms got it. Utah.